Hello everyone, myself Bhautik Trivedi, working as an assistant professor in IT ICT department of LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. I will explain you the concept of RSVP in Advanced Networking Protocol subject. So first of all of you know the mainly two protocol already I discussed. One that is the VOIP and second one that is the RTP. What is the meaning of VOIP? That is the voice over internet protocol. And second one, that is the RTP, that is the real time transport protocol. And this particular protocol, that's a part of the multimedia networking in advanced networking protocol subject. So the third protocol, that is the RSVP. So what do you mean by RSVP here? RSVP means that is related to the resource reservation protocol. So here you just see, first of all, what's the quality of service requirements behind the multimedia networking? So first of all, discuss about that. So whenever you talk about the QoS requirement in multimedia networking, so at that time that is generally divided into two type of application. One that is the real time application and second one that is the elastic application. So here you just see in this particular figure, because all of you know whenever you talk about the concept of multimedia networking, at that time whatever the talk, that is in terms of the audio and video. So here you just see in this particular figure, first of all pass the sample audio. Sample audio directly passed to the network, and from this here one graph, and the name of the graph that is known as a graph and the play out buffer, because whenever you talk about the concept of the audio and video, so at that time the most important thing in a multimedia networking, that is the concept of the buffer. But here the buffer can be treated as a play out buffer, so that is the play out buffer. And one, you set the playout point in this particular multimedia networking figure. So here you just see the QoS requirement is divided into two type of application. One that is the real-time application and second one that is the elastic application. So first of all talk about the real-time application. So in real-time application, the first one that is known as an interactive application. So interactive application example, so example that is the telephone. But here that is very sensitive to packet delay. So whenever you talk about the interactive application in multimedia networking, the most important thing that is very sensitive to packet delay. Another type of application, that is the non-interactive. Non-interactive application, the example of that is the audio video broadcasting. And must remember one thing, that is very adaptable to a packet delay situation. So currently the real time application again divided into two parts, one that is the interactive application, second one that is the non-interactive application. Interactive application very sensitive to packet delay, but non-interactive application not sensitive to packet delay. So here whenever you apply the QoS requirement in multimedia networking, the most important thing is that if you apply the guarantee of maximum delay is useful. So that is about the QoS requirement. Another one category, that is the elastic application. Again in elastic application, the first most important thing, you apply the interactive data transfer. How you applying the interactive data transfer in multimedia networking? So with using the two protocol, already you know the name of that one, that is the HTTP, and second one that is the FTP. HTTP and FTP under which category? Under the category of which layer? So application layer that supported the HTTP and FTP. Again the most important factor here in this particular diagram you just see, that is sensitive to average delay. That is sensitive to average delay. And another thing, the interactive data transfer. After that the most important thing, that is the bulk data transfer. So bulk data transfer supported two technique. One that is the mail and second one that is the news delivery. So that is totally insensitive to the delay. So here that's all about the concept of quality of service requirement in multimedia networking. So most important two points, two type of application, that is the part of that. After that, which kind of problem occur in a multimedia networking? So here you just see the different application have different delay. So whenever you talk about the multimedia networking, at that time fully concentrate on three parameters. The parameter number one, that is the delay. Parameter number one, two, that is the bandwidth. And parameter number three, that is the jitter. So delay, bandwidth and jitter, that is the most important parameter in multimedia networking. So for this, some applications are very sensitive to the changing the network condition. So according to that, you creating a different technique. So what's the solution behind this particular problem? The solution is that you make the application, that's the adaptive application. And the second thing, you can directly build more flexible network. So with using this way, you can directly solve this particular problem. After that, the most important thing, why we study RSVP. Up to this, whatever the discussion, that is totally related to the problem, totally related to the QoS requirement. So why we study RSVP? So already you know the name of one protocol, the name of the protocol, that is the TCP, Transmission Control Protocol. Connection oriented or connectionless? So TCP, that is the connection oriented protocol. So here how I apply the TCP with the use of RSVP. So here you just see the concept of this diagram. Here I creating a one graph, the graph that totally depends on the time, and second one, that is the bandwidth. So RSVP generally used for the resource reservation protocol. How I reserve the particular resource? So with using the bandwidth reservation, the main functionality of the RSVP, that is the bandwidth reservation. So whenever you talk about the TCP, so TCP not providing a constant bitrate service. So for this, again two technique here, all of you know the one term, the term that is the periodic. So periodic means all of you know, up to the after some time you apply some techniques, that is the periodic. So whenever you talk about the TCP, and already you know the TCP is not a constant bitrate service, so at that time first important parameter here, that is the slow start, and second one, that is the periodic problem. So with using this, you can directly apply the TCP technique into the RSVP. And the must remember one important term here, the TCP behavior directly lead to the best effort delivery. So that is about it, RSVP and TCP. After that, overview of RSVP, because all of you know up to this point, the RSVP means resource reservation protocol, and with using the bandwidth reservation, you can directly apply the different technique. So RSVP overview. So first one, what is RSVP? So that is a one kind of method for the application to specify the desired QoS in a particular network. Means if you want to achieve the quality of service in a particular network, so with using the RSVP method, you can do that. Which kind of protocol, which category of protocol of the RSVP? So that is the switch state establishment protocol, that is generally used for the signaling purpose. That supported the unicasting or multicasting? So that supported the multicast friendly receiver oriented environment. Again, three type of casting in a networking already you know. One that is the unicasting, one that is the multicasting, and one that is the broadcasting. Unicasting means one sender, one receiver. Multicasting means one sender to a group of receiver, and broadcasting means one sender to all the receivers. So this is the way you can directly check the condition for the multicasting. And after that, the most important point, that is the simplex reservation. Simplex, half duplex, full duplex, each and every term you know in a networking. So here that supported the simplex reservation, means that is the single direction. That supported the single direction. After that, the one most important point for the RSVP is that, why run the RSVP? So that's generally used for the it allowing the precise allocation of the network resources. Second thing, it guarantee that the quality of service. And third one, that providing the heterogeneous bandwidth support for multicasting. So that's the overview of the RSVP. After that, the design criteria behind the RSVP. So again I repeat, heterogeneous receivers, that's the first point, means that supported the multicast. According to the situation, according to the requirement, it directly varying the bandwidth. After that, merging of resource reservation. Third one, that supported the dynamic membership. After that, that supported the minimized control protocol overhead. All of you know what is the meaning of overhead in a networking. After that, SOAP state in router. What is the meaning of SOAP state in a networking? So reservation timeout if not refreshed periodically. Means if you not applying the refresh in a periodic manner, so it directly apply the timeout in reservation. That is known as a soft state in RSVP. And according to the situation, it directly adapt the routing, that is the design criteria of the RSVP. After that, this particular diagram, you just see, that's the block diagram of the RSVP. So major component of the RSVP, so first one that supported the routing, second one that is the RSVP component, third one that is the packet classifier, and fourth one that is the packet scheduler. Because all of you know, in a network, whatever the transmission is there, that is in a form of the data packets. So data packets first of all pass to the packet classifier, and from the packet classifier it directly transfer to the packet scheduler. But in between, RSVP supported the two control system. One that is known as an admission control, and second one that is known as a policy control. So admission control supported the two technique, that supported the flow specification, and that supported the filter specification. And policy control means, according to the different policy, it directly transmitting a RSVP message to the network. So here you just see RSVP message is there, routing is there, router is there, packet classifier is there, packet scheduler is there, policy control is there. So different components of the RSVP. So that is the integrated service component for a particular routing with using the concept of RSVP. After that, the most important thing, whatever I discuss up to this point, you just see in this particular figure. So RSVP functional diagram. So RSVP functional diagram generally supported the packet classifier, that supported the packet scheduler, that supported the policy control, supported the admission control, each and everything that is the part of the RSVP functional diagram. But must remember one thing, whenever you talk about the RSVP functional diagram, that fully supported the two component, one that is the host and second one that is the router. After that, whatever the flow specification, whatever the filter specification, what do you mean by flow in RSVP? So the flow means what? The set of packet traversing a network element, that is known as a flow. So packet classifier generally determine which packet belong to which flow. So that's the functionality of the packet classifier. And IP version 6 header format, all of you know. In IPv6 header format, that includes a flow label for this particular purpose. So flow label that directly determine the flow of a net, the flow of a packet. So that is about the flow in a RSVP also. After that, resource reservation model. Already I discussed one, that is the flow specification. Second one, that is the filter specification. So sender directly advertise using flow specification. Whatever I discuss in this particular point, that is the real-time communication between the sender and receiver with using the resource reservation model. So sender directly advertises using the flow specification. RSVP directly forward this advertisement to the receiver, and with using this, it directly updating the bandwidth also, updating the delay also. That is the functionality of the RSVP demo. After that, receiver directly reserve using the flow specification and filter specification. So at the receiver side, using the two component, one that is the filter specification, one that is the flow specification. After that, sender receiver directly notified for the changes, and then after, whatever the reservation in between the sender to receiver are merged in multicast case. This is the real time scenario for the communication between the sender to receiver with using the resource reservation model. So after that, RSVP messages. How many type of messages you know? Generally two type of messages, but why we use the RSVP messages in this particular thing? So here you just see the functionality of that first one. Send as data diagram directly over IP. IP means all of you know, that is the internet protocol. Second one, periodically resend this. Third one, applying the replacement for the reservation state. And last one, substitute the last lost message. whatever the message loss, you can directly apply the substitution for that. And how many type of messages? That's a part of RSVP message. Two. One, that is the path, and second one, that is the RESV. What is the meaning of RESV here? That is the reservation message. So whenever you talk about the types of the RSVP message, so mainly two type of messages. One, that is the path, and second one, that is the reservation. After that, how I apply the resource reservation with using the RSVP? Up to this, whatever, that is the discussion, that's the normal communication between the sender to receiver. After that, how I apply the reservation? So again, sender advertise using the path message and receiver reserve using the reserve message. The fully concentrate on that, mainly two messages for the RSVP. One, that is the path, second one, that is the RESV. So here flow specification is there, filter specification is there, plus policy data is there, travels upstream in reverse direction of path message. Mainly two type of thing, one that is the upstream and one that is the downstream. And must remember one thing, apply the merging of reservation also, and sender and receiver notified of the changes. So that is about the normal reservation. After that, only two or three points, the most important three points remaining in this particular RSVP. One, that is the IP multicast. How I apply the IP multicast? All of you know, when multicasting means one sender to a group of receiver. So here, with using the path message, with using the reserve message, and with using the policy data, I can directly apply the multicasting in RSVP. So here you just see in this particular figure, sender is there, in between router is there, and different receiver is there, because all of you know, one sender and two receiver, so that is known as a concept of multicasting. But one sender and one receiver, that is known as a concept of unicasting. Between the sender, two receiver, here I put the router. So path, reserve and data. So whatever the red indication, that is the path message. Whatever the blue indication, that is the reserve message. And whatever the green indication, that is the policy data. So that is about the IP multicasting with the RSVP. After that, what's the limitation of RSVP? What's the limitation? What's the current RSVP limitation is going on? So Cisco router has RSVP support. So RSVP demo available from the USC ISI. So that is run on the Solaris. And limitation is that filtering is currently based on host ID and port number only. So whenever you talk about the RSVP limitation, the most important thing is that the filtering is totally based on port number or host ID. And after that, what's the reservation technology? What's the different reservation technology available in a networking like RSVP? So first one, that is the telephone network, and second one, that is the ATM. So in telephone network, already you know, that is the circuit switching and packet switching concept. So that is the circuit based system. So the last point for the today's session, will RSVP succeed? Means whatever the discussion is that, according to the criteria, will RSVP succeed? The first point, my answer, yes. What's the reason? The reason is that supported the resource allocation, that supported the simpler mechanism. Third one, that supported the alternate adaptive technique. Fourth one, the RSVP supported the in a corporate network also. So these all are the reasons that supported the concept of RSVP, that's the success one. So that's all about the today's session of the RSVP. This particular topic, that's the part of the multimedia networking in advanced networking protocol subject. So thank you for watching.